Good morning. Any moment, Saddam Hussein set to be hanged as early as today. But will his execution set off even more violence in Iraq? Double whammy, a second major snowstorm in a week and a half, pounds Colorado, once again grounding hundreds of flights on another holiday weekend. And secret friendship. In that interview released after his death, Gerald Ford said friendship played a key role in the pardon of Richard Nixon. This as friends and family prepare to say goodbye to the former president at a private visitation today, Friday, December 29th, 2006.
From NBC News, this is Today with Matt Lauer and Meredith Vieira, live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
And good morning. Welcome to Today on a Friday morning. I'm Matt Lauer.
And I'm Ann Curry. And for Meredith this morning, who's back on Monday, good morning, everybody. There have been a lot of conflicting reports this morning about whether the U.S. government has handed Saddam Hussein over to Iraqi officials who will carry out this execution. But one thing is for certain, and that is that Saddam's days are numbered.
They certainly are. This morning, Iraq's prime minister said there will be no review of his death sentence and no delay in carrying it out. But some fear it will set off a new round of sectarian violence. So we'll go live to Baghdad for more on that story coming up in just a couple of minutes.
Then, Matt, deja vu all over again in Denver. Remember that mess at the Denver airport over the Christmas weekend? Well, it's another holiday weekend, and guess what? Another big snowstorm has struck there. And listen to this. Winter's only been around for 2 weeks, and the mile-high city has already received more snow than all of last season. Some places are getting more than 2 feet of snow. We'll have the latest on that coming up.
Then we're going to have some shocking research, a stunning report that concludes that women actually talk more than men.
It is shocking, I think. I'm shocked.
Other studies we'll be talking about have found that water is wet and the sun rises in the east.
I should hit him. Well, I'll hit him later.
This is about, you know, is it quality or quantity? One study says that women may actually say up to 3 times more words a day
than men do.
We'll get into that.
You're doing all the talking, I think. Anyway, plus, one of our favorite segments, at least for some of us, I don't know, I think we're going to be mortified, a look back at the good times we've enjoyed in 2006, some hellos and some goodbyes and some very bizarre moments. We wish some of them could be swept under the rug. I know that's one of your favorite, I'm sure. But anyway,
we'll have that one a little later. But first, let's go to Baghdad, where Saddam Hussein is set to face the executioner. NBC's Middle East correspondent Richard Engel is in the Iraqi capital with the latest on that. Richard, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt. U.S. officials say that for now, Saddam Hussein remains in coalition custody, but the Iraqi government is pushing for his transfer. The Iraqi prime minister wants Saddam to be executed by the end of the weekend.
The streets of Baghdad were empty Friday and tense as Iraqis await Saddam Hussein's execution and the violence they fear will follow it. Saddam himself is also preparing. His lawyers said Thursday that Saddam has met two of his half-brothers, also imprisoned in Baghdad, to say goodbye. Saddam reportedly told them he is ready to die. Saddam's lawyers said they have been instructed to collect their client's personal belongings, a sign the execution could be imminent. Sources close to the Hussein family told NBC News that U.S. officials contacted Saddam's daughter, Ragat, who is living in exile in Jordan, to ask her to come to Baghdad, but she refused. Saddam, she said, didn't want his wife or daughters to see him weak. In Baghdad, Iraqis who expressed little interest in Saddam's trial are now captivated by his execution. So many have scores to settle in this ancient country that invented the concept, an eye for an eye. At an auto repair shop, Ali Salim, a Shiite we interviewed at random, said Saddam's security forces killed 27 members of his extended family, accusing them of belonging to a radical party. The execution should be done without delay, he said. In a nearby coffee shop, Haji Allah said, when Saddam was executing people, he never asked for anyone's approval. Iraqis must do it because we suffered. But Saddam's supporters, many still attacking U.S. troops, say they will retaliate. The U.S. military will go on high alert to try and contain an expected surge in attacks.
The Iraqi government will also impose a strict curfew, we are told, once it announces that the execution has taken place. Matt?
Richard, let's talk more about the timing. Is there any kind of religious observance, Muslim holiday coming up over the coming days that might affect the timing of the execution?
The timing of this is very sensitive. Tomorrow, the Muslim holiday known as the Feast of the Sacrifice begins, and some Sunnis in this country say it would be offensive to carry out the execution during this holy period. They say that Shiite Muslims in this country want to sacrifice Saddam and to serve their interests. So there is a very big religious debate also surrounding the execution of Saddam Hussein.
All right, Richard, thanks. Richard Engel in Baghdad for us this morning. It's 5 minutes after the hour. Now here's Ann.
Matt, thanks. Back home, another major snowstorm out west is belting the Denver area and beyond for the second time in a week and a half. And once again, it's bad news for travelers nationwide. NBC's Leanne Gregg is in Denver this morning with more on this. Leanne, good morning.
Good morning, Ann. Those travel problems because of the 2 feet of new snow outside Denver, on top of the 2 to 4 feet from last week's blizzard. This headline says it all. This is the piled high city.
It is an absolute mess over there.
Heavy snowfall and icy roads are causing major problems. In some places, more than 2 feet has fallen in less than 24 hours.
There's at least 50 cars in the ditches on the east side of the tunnel.
Slick, snow-packed roads forced closures of parts of at least 3 major interstates.
707, now here's Matt.
All right, Ann, thanks. Now to new revelations about President Gerald Ford, who will be remembered today by his family at a private church service before his body is flown to the U.S. Capitol tomorrow. NBC's Andrea Mitchell has more on the late president's thoughts about Iraq, Watergate, and Richard Nixon. Andrea, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt. Gerald Ford believed the Iraq War was a mistake. Ford confided that and much more to Bob Woodward of the Washington Post 2 years ago, knowing it would all be revealed after his death.
Gerald Ford told Woodward he strongly disagreed with
that he held strong views. But to the best of anyone's knowledge, he never shared his doubts about Iraq with President Bush, but would have if the president had asked. Matt?
All right, Andrea, thank you very much. Andrea Mitchell in Washington for us this morning. Tim Russert is NBC's Washington bureau chief and moderator of Meet the Press. Tim, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt.
Since Andrea was just talking about the former president, let's start there with you. I mean, it's an interesting dynamic that we're going to be seeing over these next couple of days in Washington with people like President Bush praising the former president, Gerald Ford, and yet these tapes coming out with Bob Woodward and Gerald Ford being critical of this current administration.
It sure is, Matt. Gerald Ford, not an ideologue, a very pragmatic politician, right of center. But for him to offer these comments about the war...
Going back to the former president for a second, what do you expect?
Matt, it's going to be an understated state funeral compared to that of Ronald Reagan. The Ford people are very conscious of the man from Michigan, who was never elected to the presidency or the vice presidency, someone who defined his image with the American people by appearing in a bathrobe and eating English muffins. That's the kind of imagery that you will see played out through the next 3 or 4 days. A good, decent man who made a very difficult decision that was unpopular back then, pardoning Richard Nixon, that in hindsight has now been praised by historians. That's what they hope to put forward.
All right, and I know you'll be there for us, Tim, giving us your perspective, and thanks very much. What's up for the new year for you? Same thing as usual? Keg of Old Milwaukee and a noisemaker?
Well, if I can get through your birthday party tomorrow, pal.
Happy New Year.
You too, pal.
All right, and NBC News will have complete coverage as the late president's body arrives at the U.S. Capitol. That's tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. Eastern time. We'll also carry the funeral proceedings live on Tuesday starting at 10 a.m. Eastern, again, right here on NBC.
Now let's get a check of the rest of the morning's top stories from Natalie Morales, who's in for me at the news desk. Good morning, Natalie.
Good morning, Ann and Matt, and good morning, everyone. The military says 5 more U.S. troops have died in Iraq. 4 soldiers were killed by a roadside bomb while they were on patrol, and a Marine was killed in fighting in western Iraq. Now that brings the American death toll for December to 103. It is the second deadliest month this year. It was a tribute fit for a legend. Thousands of people in New York paid their respects Thursday to James Brown. Mourners and fans filed by the Godfather of Soul's open casket on stage at the Apollo Theater in Harlem, the same theater that catapulted Brown to fame. Thousands of people followed his coffin as it was transported by horse and carriage through the streets of New York. A second viewing will be held tomorrow in Augusta, Georgia. Brown died Christmas Day at the age of 73. Seven New Orleans police officers have been indicted on murder and attempted murder charges stemming from the chaotic days surrounding Hurricane Katrina. Four of the officers are accused of killing two men, one of whom was mentally retarded. Police officials say the officers were fired on first. The district attorney handling the Duke sexual assault investigation faces possible ethics sanctions. The North Carolina bar has filed ethics charges against Mike Nifong for allegedly making misleading and inflammatory statements about the athletes linked to the case. Nifong dropped the rape charges against the lacrosse players last week, but they still face charges of sexual offense and kidnapping. The body of American climber Charlie Fowler has been found buried on a snowy mountain in China. Search crews are still looking for his climbing partner, Christine Boscoff. The two were reported missing earlier this month. Nearly 3 million pilgrims are in Mecca today, carrying out the annual Hajj pilgrimage, a duty all able-bodied Muslims are expected to carry out at least once in their lives. Donning white robes, the faithful circled the holy Kaaba stone and prayed at Mount Arafat for forgiveness of their sins. This morning, Apple Computer says its own internal investigation has found no misconduct by its management and CEO, Steve Jobs. Jobs is under fire for possible mishandling of stock options. We'll have more on this story coming up. The NASDAQ will close on Tuesday in honor of former President Gerald Ford, marking a national day of mourning for his funeral. The FDA says meat and milk from cloned animals is safe to eat. Final approval, however, is months away, and the FDA is accepting public comments. And a beloved panda is recovering this morning after being wounded in the wild. 4-year-old Zhang Zhang was apparently injured in a fight with other pandas over territory. Earlier this year, the male panda made history, becoming the first of his species to grow up in captivity and then be released back into the wild. It is now 7:17. Back over to Matt, Ann, and Chris. I guess it's a tough world out in the wild.
Yeah. Panda battles? I can't imagine.
It was this world coming to.
Right. Cozy. Thanks, Natalie.
Mr. Cimino in while Al is still on vacation,
still
actually.
Still.
And you're talking about snow out west, and what else?
Pretty much it's snow out west. Yeah. There's probably the only game in town is out west, that storm system. Most of the country's pretty quiet, but Denver, you can't sell that to them. More snow heading their way again today. Probably several more inches, and the snow extends all the way up to the Dakotas. Extreme panhandle of western panhandle of Oklahoma, also extreme northwest panhandle of Texas could see a little snow today. But we're talking the possibility of another 8 to 12 or maybe even more inches of snow before all is said and done by tomorrow afternoon. Severe weather possible. East Texas, rest of the country quiet, northeast, southeast, with above normal temperatures continuing. That's a look at the national weather. Here's a look now at your local forecast. Sunday night is football night in America. Should I do it like Al?
The Bears and the Packers. It's a classic. In Chicago. Passing showers. No passing gas, just showers. Temperatures will be
in the 40s, dropping to the upper 30s. And again, just a couple of showers around. Nice way to spend New Year's Eve. A little football. And?
All right, Chris, thank you. He's worth $5 billion, and thanks to the iPod, he's become an icon. But now, Steve Jobs and his company, Apple Computer, may face a federal probe that could rock Apple to its core. Here's CNBC's Margaret Brennan.
This is how tiny it is.
He is are not scaring consumers away.
If he did that, bummer, but, I mean, the products are incredible, so. Can't complain about that.
And after a holiday season that saw Americans buying more than 15 million iPods, some doubt whether the scandal could tarnish the Apple brand.
I'm not thinking, do I buy this because of Steve Jobs? I'm thinking I buy this because I want it or not.
Apple's spokesperson says that company is fully cooperating with the SEC. Jobs has hired a lawyer.
Most people are honest.
Now, along with anticipation for the next gadget from Apple, the world is watching to see what the future holds for this great innovator. For today, Margaret Brennan, CNBC, New York.
This morning, Apple said it's restating some past financial statements, and the company also expressed its confidence in CEO Steve Jobs and said that it found no misconduct by senior management. And we should also note that NBC News has a partnership with Apple. Meanwhile, coming up in our next half hour, from Brad to Angelina to Tom and Katie and Girls Gone Wild in Hollywood, we're going to look back at some of the biggest stories on the pop culture scene in 2006. But first, this is Today on NBC.
San Diego! Daddy, baby!
Still ahead on the front. Friday morning, do women
talk more than men? Of course we do. Actually, you know, the question is, you know, is it in our nature? Is there another reason? I mean, there's a lot of possibilities. We also are going to take a look back this morning, Matt, on some of the wild and wacky moments we've had here on Today.
But first,
your local news.
January 5th, no one tells a story like Matt Lauer. The interviews, the moments, the anchor. Matt Lauer's 10th anchorversary on Today on NBC.
Friday morning, and we are looking at the 29th day of December 2006. We're also looking as though we're busting at the seams here in Rockefeller Plaza. Great crowd getting up early, enjoying a long weekend for some. And so we've decided to venture out and say good morning to the crowd. As we try and do, catching our breath here, take a look around here.
Wow.
We've got a certain pre-holiday crowd here. Good morning. Nice to see you. How are you? I'm Matt Lauer,
happy
along
New
with the
Year.
Kissing Bandit, Ann Curry, who's saying hi to the nice people.
Oh, Happy New Year. A lot of
almost.
People.
And coming up in this half hour, you know, on this program every day we cover very serious topics domestically and abroad. But one of the great things about the Today Show and our jobs, we also get to have some more fun, some lighter moments. And so this morning, courtesy of videotape and some editors who will no longer work here, we're
going to
take
too.
You back and show you some of the lighter moments we've enjoyed here on the show in the year 2006, some hellos and some goodbyes as well.
Yeah, and also we're going to be talking about taking on the age-old question, do women really actually talk more than men? Your opinions aside, Matt, we're going to actually take a look at a revealing study and find out why it is a very bad idea for women to say to their men, honey, let's talk. But first, today's time capsule, the breakups, the breakdowns, the babies, and the bombshells. It was a busy year on the pop culture scene, and here's NBC's Peter Alexander.
The pop culture scene was an endless party in 2006, and everyone...
This past year saw a lot of changes right here on the Today Show. We said farewell to a very good friend, spent the summer outdoors, rebuilt our studio, and gained a new member of our family.
Oh, exhausting.
And as usual, we had a lot of laughs along the way, so it's time to stroll down memory lane and look back at the fun we had in 2006.
Here we go. 30 seconds. Seven, six, five, four, three.
Good morning.
What we're gonna do right here is go back.
Morning, gentlemen.
Guys,
morning.
Morning.
How are you? I'm Matt.
Oh my God.
We're gonna pose a bit though.
Reach in and grab those handles.
Can you feel them?
That's not the handle.
Right.
We'll see you at the bottom.
It's not goodbye, but a heartfelt thank you for 15 great years.
Studio 1A is getting a much-deserved and kind of much-needed facelift.
Ooh.
If you could have a superpower,
guy.
What superpower would you want?
To fly, no question. Yeah.
Invulnerability.
I want to read people's minds.
Oh, that's a very manly one.
See, I think it tells so much about people's personalities, the way you answer this. You want to control the world. I just want to get home without having to sit in traffic.
There is a dragonfly about this long.
I noticed.
In the lights above
it's about,
us.
It's about this long.
And I just want to note that if it flies near us, you're going to hear me scream like a little girl.
Starting to get to me.
It's like standing up in a gale force wind on the plaza.
Let the rain come down.
The rain was coming sideways, so our papers were getting wet.
Meredith Vieira is here.
Hi, I'm Matt.
Oh.
Nice to meet you.
Matt Lauer?
Nice to meet you. Hope you get my name.
As usual, Miss Vieira.
Do you think you have the chops for the job?
Yes, I think I have the chops for the job. We'll be back in a moment, but today. But first, this. What are you guys doing? Let me out.
You ever thought about doing something else?
I just got this gig. Leave me alone. I'm Meredith Vieira, here with Matt Robert.
I got nervous when you had to go down and read our names.
Matt Lauer.
Does everybody have to do this when they join the Today Show?
In a key scene from the 1976 classic All the President's Men, Deep Throat tells Bob Woodward to follow the what?
From what I understand, same thing your agent said during the negotiation.
Daydreaming.
Oh, that wasn't that bad. You know, not an audible groan.
Did you know that you were saving this network?
Well, you know, you and me both.
Here's something that I don't think most people know. You're from Alabama.
No, I'm not.
You're not.
People don't know that.
That is wrong.
I know it's wrong.
We work an average of 9 weeks more per year here than the average European does.
What's up with that?
So we're encouraging you today, at least the people who are behind Take Back Your Time Day, encourage you to go home a little early today.
Okay.
Spend time around.
Okay, see you later. Bye.
Spend time around the dinner. Not you.
I want you to shout out the weather, though, Al.
Okay. Our top story today.
Well, I've got to pee. There's a woman who's lost 100.
Well, you better go right now.
Scientists have discovered a pattern of 20 feet.
Oh, you're not going to do it over, are you?
Oh, my God.
Wait.
Okay. All right. 5, 4, 3.
That's it.
Okay, you are not allowed in here during this fix.
Well, we're just here to support you.
Yeah, we want to help you. We all know Ann Curry is a great news person, but did you know that she also hosts Ann Curry's Dance Party?
We have a new edition of the Dance Party.
It's you this
That's
time.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the Al Roker Dance Party.
Check your weather.
We want to introduce you to the sequel,
the Natalie Morales Dance Party.
Roll that rock catch footage.
Take a bite.
All right.
It's poison.
Good.
Oh, don't get that.
No, she, I think she said it was poison. First, your local news.
We got a hit to news. We got a hit. We got a hit to news. We got a hit. We got a hit to news.
Yeah.
What kind of world do you want? Baby, baby. Let's start in the start. Build a nice start. Be careful what you wish for.
It's always fun and a little horrifying to look back.
I hope Meredith is watching that.
Yeah, you know, it's too bad she wasn't here today, but yeah. We'll run it again on Monday, Tuesday when she's here.
She'll see it over and over again.
It's a good way to fill time. Let me just take a second and thank Erica Levins, Lindsay Smith, Chris Connell, Amanda Avery, and William Honcannon for putting that piece together. I mean, imagine what it takes to sit there and actually think during the entire year. Well, let's save that to videotape, but let's put that and then to put it all together in a way that doesn't offend anybody, or at least not the two of us.
We're lucky that they're very talented.
Anyway, you had a good time. Anything that hard that made you feel bad? Anything you want to talk about? No.
I might need a couch. I've recovered. Then you're still recovering from Elmo, huh?
Oh, that's right. Well, when I attacked him, and because I was just giving him a bunch of kisses, and then Al goes, "And he's only 4 years old."
You're not supposed to be doing that
horrified.
To the child's idol. Anyway, we're back with much more of Today on a Friday morning right after this. For stopping in, she did an open, two shots of tequila, and left.
And had some cake.
We want to thank Chris Cimino for helping out all week, too.
Well, it's great to be here.
Happy birthday to you and Meredith this weekend.
Thanks.
And coming up on Monday, we should tell everybody the first day of 2007. We're going to have a look ahead at the new year in finance, politics, and how we can do a little celebrating.
Plus a preview of pop culture from movies to TV to the music of 2007 and Lionel Richie.
Have a happy and safe new year.
From today, the trees trimmed at 30 Rock.
Music,
time to shop.
Crazy! Oh, we got a little tree here.
So
some screaming girls.
Going the extra
mile.
Gotcha.
Turn the hands around.